Welcome to Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, the arena of the supernatural, where supernatural is natural. Our vision is to bring Christ's abundant life, knowledge, and hope to Inanda, then to the whole world, in the form of preaching, teaching, holistic gospel, healing, deliverance, counseling, training, and discipleship. Here we go. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, Jesus is Lord. That single belief calls us together as a community and sends us into our world with hope and purpose. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, your past will never define your future. There is always redemption, which means there is always a brighter day. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we do not think that we are better than any other church out there. We are just doing our best to become our best. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we want you to believe in God, but also we want you to know that God believes in you. We are not against any people who do not attend church anywhere. Instead, we pursue them with love, the very same love that is pursuing us. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we are committed to serve God and people. We take ownership and account for our decisions, answerable or accountable as for something within one's power. We do what we say we will do. We are learning to serve God with all our hearts, and we are learning to worship Him with all our lives. And if you are looking for the perfect church, we are not it. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we will make mistakes, but we will choose to grow from them. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we are part of a global community that is knit together by the resurrection of Jesus. And by the way, at Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we believe that really happened too. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, we will engage with people who are in real need because we are the hands and feet of Christ. And finally, we need you to hear this loud and clear. At Mount Zion Carnation Ministries, it's not our church at all, but it is His, and we live and move and breathe in His church for His glory and fame, and not for ours. So there's the invitation. You are invited to jump in with your whole heart, at your own pace, and experience the life that awaits you in Christ. Friends, this is gonna be good. Welcome to Mount Zion Carnation Ministries. From Drs. Swanem Somi and Thabisile Msomi.
Mangisuga go with cheese. Isugago etches. Gizotala nawe. Gego konze njalo. Hallelujah. Cela samgelu baba wethu a stage uDokotela Swane Msomi ngezandla enkulu simamkele.
Your life will be transformed. Yabona mangithi transform, I'm saying izobhubhuka isuke laphana ke iyobekeka kwenye indawo. Ingakho nje ubona ke sihlele idudweni ezinhle kangaka bakithi ke. We are celebrating the Passover. Ingakho ke sithi ihloko sethu kuleli Pasika sithi the benefits of Passover. So masikhuluma ngebenefit yePassover sisho ukuthi nje ini sayithola ngePassover. Namhlanje you're going to hear my pastors. Bengisaba chaza kanjalo ngithi kunomfundisi lapha na ke umchunu bakithi kozosivulela inkundla bese kuba nomfundisi ke ke ontombi yezi mamkhoma ezulu shezi usho njalo mayithula lapha ku radio bese kuzoba nomfundisi ke lapha na ke nomcebo Gumede ayibo sengithi Gumede Dlamini yayiza leyo nto leyo then ke bese soba no pastor Hlengiwe Myeza. I'm telling you, you're gonna be blessed, and also we're gonna have umfundisi Musamthe all the way from Beckville. You're gonna be blessed. I'm telling you, your life will never be the same again. Iskatse to sok celebrator, iskatse to sok jabula, iskatse to sogu togoza. Please chela na bangan bako ba chele bonke, chela bonke, chela bonke, nyan bona niangena na panage, niatu telega, chela bonke, and tell them ogute that time has finally come. Yes, we're gonna be blessed. I'm going to introduce my pastors one by one this time, then so that you're gonna be blessed. And I'm telling you, you are going to nzoba introduce again. Ngokwelokhu ngokwamazwi abo njengoba bezoshumayela namhlanje ke, I'm going to introduce them basibingelele ukuthi bakhona, then emva kwalokho ke ngizobe sengibadedela ke umuntu ngamunye ngamunye uzothatha leyo 10 minutes nomshana wami laphana ke eyintambeni ke uzobe ngibhekela laphana ke isikhathi ke ewu time keeper ngendlela isimanga ke and laphana ke operatela laphana ke kuma visuals ethu uHangi and ke uRoland Musavaho Hangi indoda yakhona le ya ngiyakutshela wena uhambile kakhulu bese kuzoba untokozo laphana ke kwi-car radio ke usibambele kanjalo ke iy'ntambo ukuthi i-audio yethu bonke abasilalele kwi-car radio laphana ke bazozwa laphana ophethe iy'ntambo laphana ke untokozo ke Pretty Makhanya. Ngizothi nje over to you laphana ke mfundisi ke Ayanda all the way from eClermont, we assembly yase eClermont. Siya welcome ke mfundisi wami umchunu, welcome.
Shalom Tess.
Shalom shalom, over to you baba ke nezwi lokuqala uzosinikeza lona la sithi khona baba forgive them, they don't know what they do. Over to you baba.
Amen. Qale ngibonge kakhulu baba for ithuba engitholayo just to share a word kwisikhathi la khona uJesu ke owafela khona izono zethu wayesiphambaneni wakhuluma la mazwi ayisikhombisa. UNkulunkulu bazalwane uthembekile and into ayenza esiphambanini iyashintsha impilo yethu ngokupheleleyo. Namhlanje asisafani nakuqala ngenxa yemisebenzi uJesu awenza esiphambanini egameni likaJesu. So ubona izinto zethu namhlanje la izikhona kungumusa kaJesu and ubele bakhe ngenxa yomsebenzi awenza esiphambanweni. Namhlanje izinto zethu sesikhululekile ngenxa yalokho uJesu akwenza esiphambanweni. So sibonga kakhulu nje baba egameni kaJesu. Amen.
Amen.
So funda lapha encwadini kaLuka chapter 23 verse 34 uJesu uyasho lapha uthi Father forgive them for they don't know what they do. Amen. May God bless the reading of his word. Amen. Simthola uJesu esho lamazwi lana ethi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. Amen. Ngoba empeleni babengakwazi abakwenzayo. So uJesu lana uthi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. uJesu uthini lana? Lana kwakuyihola likaJesu lokugcina. But into ayikhetha ukuyikhipha kulomzuzu ukuthi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. Lesi sisho lesu uJesu ayishole lelizwi leluJesu alishoyo usho umkhuleko kubaba uNkulunkulu ukuthi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. So uJesu akaziceleli yena la but ucelela abantu bakhe uthi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. Yizo lokuqala leluJesu alikhipha esenhlungwini. Wakhetha ukungazinaki izinhlungu awayekuzona but wathi baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenzayo. Ukuba kwakuyimina ebuhlungwini uJesu ayekubona, ngangizocela ubaba uNkulunkulu ukuthi baba siza mina kuqala ngoba ngisenhlungwini zokushawa, ngisenhlungwini emzimbeni wami, ngiphuma igazi. Cela baba uqala usize mina but uJesu wathi hayi okwamanje ngeke ngicelele mina, wakhetha ukucelela thina and he's more concerned for abantu aba responsible for ukumbethela esiphambanweni. He's more concerned for those people ababezombethela and he's more concerned for impilo zabo. Wathi baba baxolele ngoba bakwazi abakwenzayo. Wacela uxolo kubaba uNkulunkulu ukuthi akabaxolele ngoba bakwazi abakwenzayo. Bamfaka esiphambanweni nje abakwazi abakwenzayo. Bayamthuka nje abakwazi abakwenzayo. So uJesu he's more concerned for impilo zabo kunokuthi azicelele yena for idingo zakhe ngaleso sikhathi leso. Uthi baba baxolele ngoba bakwazi abakwenzayo. Kunokuba azicabangele yena, wakhetha ukucabangela thina. Kunokuba azicabangele yena, wakhetha ukucabangela abantwana bakhe. Wakhetha ukucabangela imiphefumulo esengozini yokubhujiswa. Wathi baba, baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo. And he's more concerned for imiphefumulo esengozini yokuya ebhubheni. That's why wathi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo. Ngoba uJesu esho lomkhuleko lona ukhulekela wonke umuntu. Ukhulekela thina sonke samfaka esiphambanweni. Umuntu engayibuza ukuthi ngamfaka kanjani uJesu esiphambanweni. But sonke we are responsible for ukuthi uJesu afe esiphambanweni ngenxa yezono zethu, ngenxa yobubi bethu, ngenxa yezono esasinazo, ngenxa yobuthakathaka bethu. Manje uJesu kwakumele esiphambanweni ngenxa yethu. Uyasho la ukuthi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo. Abakwazi abakwenzayo. Njengoba bebulalana nje emhlabeni, njengoba chitheka igazi, abakwazi abakwenzayo. Izono ziyangokwanda njena, abakwazi abakwenzayo. Bayaqhubeka benza izono, bayabulalana, bayathakathana egameni likaJesu. Jesu uthi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo. UJesu is more concerned for abantwana bakhe abaqhubekayo beyone but yena uthi baba baxolela abakwazi abakwenzayo. Njengoba impilo zethu siyiphatha kanje namhlanje sibulala umzimba wethu ngesikufaka phakathi, uJesu uthi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo. Xolela izono zabo ngoba abakwazi lokho abakwenzayo ukuthi kuzobabhubhisa ekugcineni, but mina ngikhona for ukuthi ngibe yisacrifice for impilo zabo. And then uJesu ke uthi baba baxolele abakwazi abawenzayo ngoba weyazi uJesu ukuthi ngaphandle kokuthi esiphambanweni ngeke kube khona ukuxolela kwezono kwakudingeka uJesu ayesiphambanweni for izono zethu kuba zixolele ingunaphakade wayebusela ubudlelwane phakathi kwethu nobaba ngenxa yezono zethu izono zethu zazisimbozile ukuba singabi nomdlelwana noNkulunkulu but uJesu wakhetha ukuthi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo abakwazi abakwenza kunina but wena baxolele ngenxa yegazi lami engizochitha njengamanje uJesu ke lapho ke elapho khona ke azoxolela khona izono zethu mhla maseselenge esiphambaneni iforgiveness ibalekile and uJesu la uyasifundisa ukuxolela uyena waqale wasixolela ngenxa yezono zethu ngenxa yobuthakathaka bethu walenge esiphambaneni wacela uxolo kubaba wathi baba baxolele abakwenza abakwenzayo ngoba yena wakhokhela izono zethu wakhokhela isikweletu yena wayengasikweleti isikweletu sasikhokhe isikweletu esasikweletwa yithina but yena wakhetha ukusikhokhela sona leso sikweletu wakhetha ukufela thina ngoba thina sasingakwazi ukusikhokha lesi sikweletu sasidinga umuntu ozofela izono zethu but uJesu enguNkulunkulu wasacrifice wathi ngizoza ngizofela abantu bami esiphambaneni ukuze izono zabo zixolele. Namhlanje sesikhululekile ngenxa yokuxolela ngoJesu ezonweni zethu. Kukho konke ke uJesu uyasifundisa lana ukuxolela. Kuthi it doesn't matter ukuthi abantu bakone kangakanani. It doesn't matter ukuthi bayaqhubeka bayakona noma usukhuluma iqiniso bangalizwa, but uthi yena baba baxolele ngoba abakwazi abakwenza kubalekile ukuba noxolo ngoba uJesu waqala wasixolela yena kuqala nathi sibaye kubalekile ukuthi ke abasonayo sibaxolele mihla namalanga ngoba uJesu wakwazi nathi ukusixolela nathi ke asikwazi ukubela abantu ngoba lize lithi izwi lika Mateyu forgive those xolela laba abakonile njoba naye uxolele kulokhu ke okuneni kwakho nawe kumele ukwazi ukufunda ukuxolela abantu abakonile ngoba uNkulunkulu waqala yena ukuxolela wena waqala yena ukuxolela ukuxolela wena nokuthi ahlanze izono zakho ebubuni bakho so ukubalekile ke wazi uxolo ngoba uNkulunkulu unoxolo nawe uJesu unoxolo nawe so ilamazi uJesu awakhuluma esiphambaneni wathi baba baxolele abakwazi abakwenzayo namhlanje impilo zethu zila ezikhona namhlanje ingenxa yoxolo uJesu alenza phakathi kwethu nobaba ukuba kasixolele and sibuyele kwiposition la uNkulunkulu ayisibekele kuyona naye sibe ne-relationship naye kubalekile ke bazalwane ukuthi sazi ke ukuthi uxolo lubalekile abakunayo ubaxolele ngoba nawe uNkulunkulu ukuxolele wena onganawo amandla okususa izono owawunazo okuhlanza izono owawunazo but uJesu wakhetha ke ukusifela esiphambaneni ukuze izono zethu zixolele so kubalekile kuba sazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu usixolelile ebubini bethu uNkulunkulu uhlanzile izono zethu namhlanje sesikhululekile so asifunde ukuxolela nokwazi ukuxolela nokuthi ke uJesu naye wasixolela Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Siyabonga kakhulu umfundisi uMchunu ngokusinikeza nangosikhumbuza nje kuvula nje umlomo wakhe uJesu evula nje wathi nje baba baxolele ngoba bakwazi abakwenza inkonzo ye reconciliation yokubuyisa abantu noNkulunkulu bangaxabani. Siyabonga kakhulu umfundisi uMchunu that was powerful baba. We thank you very much. Umfundisi uMchunu okhona lapha na ke eClermont ke la ekhona ke ngezwi ke asinikezelwa namhlanje ukuthi baba baxolele ngoba bakwazi inkonzo yokuxolela inkonzo ebalekile futhi reconcile phakathi uNkulunkulu wayixolela ethi nje baxolele baba abantu phakathi uJesu mediator ke onomcebo ke Dlamini all the way from Centerkow and also Bellington over to you from this one
ngiyabonga ngibingelela abazalwane ngibingelela befundisi ubaba nomama nabalaleli bonke egameni lika Jesu Kristu waseNazareth sikulo iphusika ngibonga kakhulu izwe ngizolenza lithi John 19:26-27 women behold the son say to the disciple behold the mother ngizocela ukufunda nangesiZulu because ilangile understand ekhona kahle la khona kuthiwa uthe uJesu ebona unina nomfundi amthandayo bemi ngakhona wathi kunina mama bheki indodana yakho wayesethi kumfundi bheka unyoko kusukela kuleso sikhathi umfundi lowo wamyisa kwakhe uma sibheka ke lapha uverse 26 la khona uJesu ethi ebabona lithizwe likaNkulunkulu babemi ngakhona meaning they were nearby but to me it seems as if they couldn't even identify who they are nearby and to me it seems as if they couldn't see each other but it called for Jesus ukuthi abenze babonane I don't understand noma omunye wayefokase kuJesu nomunye efokase kuJesu but it seems as if they were aligned and they were waiting for an opportunity to ukuthi bangene with destination yabo lento ke ithi kumina sonke siyamdinga uNkulunkulu sonke siyadinga a higher authority who will instruct us uJohn wayekade trainwa uJesu along the way emtrainer emnikeza uthando emphatha uthando lolu azi ukuthi lento kuzohamba kahambe uJohn enze njani ayidinge lento ukuze naye aphinde ayidlulisele kwabanye so kanjalo nathina siyadinga a higher authority okuzothi mangabe ezokwazi ukubona ukuthi now we are right by our destination now but thina ngoba sazi la siyakhona ithi lento baba mayeyisho ngelinye ilanga uthi ilead iyona eyazi ukuthi siyapi yiko kumele ngesinye isikhathi njalo sifokase ku leader because he knows the destination he knows ukuthi kuyiwa kuphi no Jesu weyazi ukuthi what is the right time ukuthi abatshele it called for Jesus ukuthi aba instruct ukuthi mama ebheka na indodana ndodana nangumame then ngaleso sikhathi sizothi uJohn kusho ukuthi mabe seqala sefocusa give me the like blessing yami neyomunye neyakho isukisi seduze kodwa wena ukwazi ukuyibonela right sikwi isikhathe new era sisekhathini khona la si part of uJesu wasinqobela yila khona sithi sinamandla okwenza konke ngaye uJesu siqinisayo kodwa sikwazi uvele singenele kwi new era singazange siasharishwe i leader okufanele isinstruct now is the time for you ukuthi ungene kwi new era ithini ke lento ithi God will never give you go ahead if he sees ukuthi awukho aligned at the time awukho aligned and uNkulunkulu ebona ukuthi times and seasons you don't understand ukuthi which time is this which season is this yes you can be trained but if ukuthi you are not focused and you don't know what time is it you don't know what season is that then you need a higher authority as of instruct ukuthi now is the right time ukuthi uthi jump in uma sibheke uJesu ngesikhathi ebatshela ethi mama na indodana indodana nangu mama sizwa kuthiwa babe wabe umfundi esethatha uMaria esehamba naye lithi wamthatha wahamba naye manje ufunda kahle ngeZulu lithi wayesethi kumfundi bheka unyoko kusukela kuleso sikhathi umfundi lowo wamyisa kwakhe after that asiza ukuthi uMaria waphele lapha ngiphindanga ngeze ukuthi uMaria wabe sephele lapha ithini lento kimina nomunye ithi lento once the leader has ushered you to a new era wakuhlanganisa ne destination yakho nesibusiso sakho ne blessing yakho that you've been waiting for that you've been trained for we've been trained sinikezwa kuthiwa sithi shalom isibhekana nezimo asingakhulumi oku-opposite kepha asikhulume thina oku-positive I mean hayi oku-negative ngaleso sikhathi we're in the training now is the time to produce what we have been trained for like uJesu ubese etshala kuJohn uJohn manje sekuyisikhathi sokuthi aproduce loko kade ku-impartwa loko kade trainwa ngako loko kade kutshalwa kuyena same thing applies to us ukuthi sekuyisikhathi ukuthi lento that we've been trained for sekuyisikhathi ukuthi produce but kanjani a leader should announce a new era thina le ase u-announcile already thina ngamandla kaJesu sesinamandla ke manje ukuthi singene kulento le asifaka kuyona only if thina ukuthi we aligned with our leader we are aligned with our blessing uma sibheka kusho ukuthi blessing yethu masinqwamane nayo ngenxa yokusharishwa is the higher authority yes asharisha angeke siphinde sidiphathe kwi blessing yethu the blessing ikhona lento athu baba isibusiso sika uNkulunkulu siyaxebisa sinezelo usize. It means if le blessing is ngendlela okuyiyona that we have been waiting for and sayinikezwa kwahamba ngokwama channels sayinikezwa by the leader ngeke size sihlukane nayo siyohlala nayo forever ngoba angizwa la kuthiwa khona uMaria waphinda wahlukana futhi no John angizwa la kuthiwa wahlukana khona. It seems as if Jesus had opened their eyes even though they were too close to each other, but it seems as if bebengabonani. It calls for the leader to open my eyes ukuze ngibone ukuthi where am I going, because yena uyazi ukuthi where am I going. So ithini lento kumina? Ithi angibuke ophezulu, angifocus bese ngibe aligned with the times and season, aligned with my blessing, aligned with my calling. It tells me very well ukuthi even if ngathiwa I've got the calling over my life and ngiyazi ukuthi fanele ngiye kuphi nini, but whenever the higher authority or my leader has not told me ukuthi sekuyisikhathi manje ukuthi uye kule ndawo, I have to wait for the right time. I am reminded by myself ukuthi khona isikhathi la ngake ngafohla khona ngenkani ngoba ngithi lento ngiyayizwa ama goosebumps kumina, wathi ubaba stop, ngathi ngiyayizwa ngahamba ngayo kwa-Maritzburg, but ngoba it was not the right time. The leader knew why he was saying stop, it's not yet the time, but mina I persisted ngathi no, I'm carrying on because I could feel ama goosebumps ngaphakathi mina ukuthi okay, now ngifuna ukwenza lento, ngifisa ngazi ukuthi leli evangeli ngahamba, but akuzange kuhambe kuphumelele ngoba the leader knew very well that I'm not yet aligned with Pietermaritzburg. So ithi kuthina lento, kumele sibe aligned with our calling, with our blessing, kumele sibe aligned with the higher authority. Uzobuka yena abone ukuthi now is the right time ukuthi unomceba sondele, now is the right time ukuthi unomceba usekwi new era manje. I can usher her in, I can just instruct her. Now she is awaiting for an instruction, even my blessing is awaiting for the voice from above ukuthi ithi ithini voice, ithi now blessing go to Nomcebo, Nomcebo come to the blessing and hold your blessing throughout the whole life or eternally. So ithi lento asibuke phezulu. Ngikhumbula ubaba mayethi babheka phezulu ubuso babo bakhanya, angikhumbula ukuthi ubuso bakhanya baphinde futhi bangakhanya, no bakhanya. If thina sifocusile and si aligned, silalela ongaphezulu kuthina, yila khona ezothina ubaba, yila ezothi khona mame, or blessing bheka nangu Nomcebo, hlangana naye. Le nto besiyilindile sitrainwa Mount Zion Incarnation Ministries, now is the time ukuthi le zinto ebesizilindile zenzeke ey'mpilweni zethu, because it is the time of the new era. It is the time whereby sihlangane nezinto ebesihlezithi kuyashiwo kodwa zenzeke, but now is the time, isikhathi sokuthi izinto zenzeke on if we focus la esibizelwe khona egameni likaJesu. Ngiyabonga.
Amen and amen and amen. Thank you very much. Sibonge laphana ke kumfundisi ke nika uNomcebo Dlamini all the way from Centerkow and Bellington. Siyabonga kakhulu mfundisi wami. UNkulunkulu akubusisa kwenzele kuhle. We are blessed. Usebenze kahle sokuna namhlanje tonight.
Hello.